at all. If that does get locked in for Jensen, that is really his bread and butter champion, I would say.
Yeah.
This is a pretty reasonable, well-rounded composition. And I mean, I don't know how heavily they want to commit. I think in a drawn-out fight, it should go the way of TL, but they're getting poked down, and this is going to come down to a smite fight, looks like.
Flash stun, they've got the combo. Yankos is not going to be rented. The heal comes down in time. The flash auto is first blood for
camp difference. I mean, you've got the 5 farm lead for Jensen in mid, but Broxah now, speaking of a fight in the mid lane, though, CoreJJ dropped pretty low, has the punch for the shield if he needs it.
They'll jump forward. Big punch, shockwave onto 3. Yankos is burning down. Team looking for their second kill, and they're going to grab it on the Jensen. Ulti in.
You would say it's going in the favor of Tactical. Tactical's actually up 2 levels on perks right now. That's the other thing, is that you're missing so much experience directly. That being said, G2 may just want to try to break out from the laning phase. They are such a strong macro team. Over onto Yankos. Broxah has been taking away camps from Yankos as well. They're going for the engage now
out of
Jensen.
What a play out of Mickey. The dunk back is not going to be enough. He gets the kill. He gets the money. And he's going to walk right back out. Look at the combo. Look at the freaking damage.
Play the map. Try to get themselves as much gold and experience as they possibly can before they are forced to fight, which is probably going to come to a head at this next Dragon. I don't think they're going to want to give up Soul.
Oh, there's the Hex Flash headbutt. Pulverize Tactical gets the flash away, pulls in a support.
Just be able to do a better job against the CoreJJ Impact duo. But Core looking to set up here on Perks.
Here's the flash engage. Shockwave going to miss. Let's Perks flash away. The autos, the punch. It's going to be maybe enough, but he autos. He's going to not quite stay alive. Or could not be enough healing. Ignite takes him down. A kill in the mid lane and top, or sorry, mid lane outer should fall as well.
Looks like Jensen coming to answer this wave, defend the tower, and TL going to be able to take another tower down.
The whole squad grouped up together, but Ashe is on the wrong side of the map. This is a 5-on-4 if TL can make their way in. Kalista ulti is up, Impact gets the slow. He can ult in for the extra slows as well. Tactical throws in CoreJJ, stun lands the backside, gets a shield. That is a low health bar. Tactical gets shut down, another kill to Mickey X. And here comes the re-engage, 5-on-4 for G2. Caps dives in, will be shut down.
The outer tower going down. 14 Liquid, just the one charge will be enough to knock that out. A great spear from Yankos, not have the TP, could be somewhat detrimental, but they have spotted Impact and they're gonna try to look for a pick.
Runs pretty quick though, still on Boots 1, but he's gonna be headbutt pulled, then wanders nearby, finds himself a shield, walks away, but this is a 5v1. Impact ult, they're still gonna be in range, they might find the slow, flash of the way, still gets stunned, still gets picked off. Perfect time for G2, but looks like TL wants to fight anyway. Core goes to dunk, only hits one, stuns in
Burns
the
in
AD
trouble.
Carry, burns a stopwatch, they're gonna find the kill thanks to Jensen. Re-engage so good, G2 knocks down the Team Liquid support, the chase is still in, Mickey X running a bit low, the flash on a tactical, QSS keeps him alive, flashes in for the auto, Ren finds it, but he's traded back all the same. Caps now fighting Brox, another kill comes in for Jensen, and the chase is still on. Yankos, dangerously low, Q is gonna land, and Jensen finds his third kill of the fight, and Team Liquid take that battle with only a single G2 member remaining.
G2 kill Impact, but TL are able to turn it around on a good engage there from CoreJJ and Jensen, lining it up to catch Perks in that shockwave to take him down, put themselves to sole point here. Jensen now in a position to carry. We've gotten more done there, but he is looking incredible in this game. Impact may be in some trouble here. G2 trying to collapse once again.
But he's surviving, honestly.
If you show, TL could actually do Baron. And he's actually just straight up beating Wonder in this 1v1 right now.
Holding the ult. He's going to put the storm down. And now how much more is going to happen as he jumps in for this
Jensen's
fight?
Coming.
He's running low on health. And here comes Jensen. He's going to go for the kill first. The shields can come after. Let him die. It's a trade of 1-for-1. Mid lane is both getting kills. And now another battle in the
Mickey's
bottom river.
Too.
Mickey's in a bad spot. He's running. But Phase Rush gets him pretty far away. Jensen finds himself the one-on-one. And Mickey is running out of time. The headbutt backwards won't do too terribly much. Nice sidestep there for Broxah. The dunk can help guarantee it. And finally, end
right
the
now,
line.
Wonder TPing in the mid lane. Yep. G2 will challenge.
Make or break moment for G2. They cannot afford to lose this fight and the Baron thereafter. Teleport's coming in all across the board. This is the battle, and Mickey can't be a part of it. Stun on Perks. Burns QSS. Flash in for Core. Finds a stun, but cannot
and
get.
We'll see if TL can make anything from that in a while, but Broxah looking like he's caught out.
He is in danger. Great flash gets away from the pulverize.
Arrow.
But here comes the arrow. Not going to step this one either. Will get away. Here comes the shield. Here comes the re-engage. Caps getting low. Has to kite away. Jensen, of course, in range for most of this one. And be careful, because Mickey's coming as well. He's coming for the play. He's going to find the headbutt, going to find the pulls. Not going to find much more than the arrow. Shockwave makes Jensen go godlike, and Impact's back in there as well. Not sure you're going to find this one. Yanko's kites away. A double kill yet again for Jensen, and the re-engage looking for more. Core JJ, no ulti just yet, but they do have Kalista for the follow-through. Runs in, finds the stun. Here comes round number two.
They're all dead.
Kill number three, and kill number four.
Their first loss here at Worlds 2020, and Team Liquid coming alive when they needed it most, have struggled.
They will take battles that look bad
the flank
and
from
make
Mickey
them
Wonder.
Look good. Wonder, a big deal. Mickey here as well. Here comes the play. Can they secure the soul? Smite comes through, they grab it. Here comes the engage. Big stun comes across. Jumps back.
Perks
and
isn't in the
shut
fight.
Down Orianna. Do they have enough for the rest of it? Wonder will drop down as well. Two for one so far, and Mickey X is on the run. A double kill for Broxah, a headbutt to a minion. Surely he cannot survive this one. Team Liquid claim the soul.
At the very least, going to be able to secure one inhibitor.
Versus around, going to find the slow. Tio will cheat up to go for the inhib itself. They'll claim that. They'll run back as fast as they can. Respawns are coming. Teleports won't be up for a flank.
It is incredibly difficult to team fight here for G2.
G2. Played as patiently as they can. Team Liquid waited it out. Once the minions are there, the sixth man guarantees that siege is easy.
They're
and
still
we start
Supers
again.
Bot, so it's tough now, because if TL go for this, Perks isn't here, and they're going to go for the dive.
They go now, they dunk. Core is in. He cannot be pulled back in time because of the threat on the back line. It's one for zero, and Mickey bought so much space, but he may lose his life for it. The ulti's going to time out soon, and there's not going to be another headbutt in time. He will drop. It's a one for one, a trade of supports, but the wave is inside the base. It is knocking down on the Nexus turrets, and that means Cat shows up. Yes, the turret will live, but it once again means the team is sent back and that TL can try again.
And critically, Caps has no flash now. They're gonna dive onto Perks.
Dunk turns off the turret. Perks gonna get away with the QSS. Impact getting low, gets the shields to stay alive. And now the inhibitor is laid bare and TL will knock this one down. Baron respawns in 40 seconds with supports respawning in 10. Should be an easy reset and a setup again for this top river.
Team Liquid now, multiple inhibitors have been knocked down in the base of G2. They're gonna reset. They're gonna try to get vision around that Baron, and it's gonna be so difficult.
Oh, this is such a play. That stun's gonna land. Is there more? If TL did not perfectly sync their recalls, if they were off by 2 seconds, Brox is stunned and no one else is there, and it's jungler dead when Baron spawns. That was almost a game-winning arrow from Perks. It was a second and a quarter off from it being that, but it was in fog. He couldn't have known any better. End of the day, TL get most members back, but they have not recalled,
exactly,
refreshed their health, refreshed their mana, or shopped since that siege.
Oh, and Mickey over the wall here could go for a big play. If he gets vision, he sees tactical now.
Gets the headbutt pulverized. QSS running away, gonna stay alive, and the arrow gonna be tanked up by Core JJ. Mickey goes for the game winner, but it's not gonna be enough. Here come the re-engage, though. Wonder wants in, looking for the re-engage now. Onto Broxah. He's squishy, he'll be stunned. He gets the shield, though, and stays alive. But look at the health bars on TL. 4 of the 5 are below half HP.
Here comes Impact.
Tries, gets the stun. Mickey back in there as well, but tactical, gonna find one, gonna find two. He's gonna lose his support, but he is still alive. Kill number three comes across. The dunk
That's
over
it.
The top. And if I learned anything from Worlds, that G2 on the LEC cannot beat play-in teams. Yankos on the way out, Impact on the chase. Minions in the bot side, and Team Liquid, they're not TPing in the base until now. Now they show up to knock down the turrets, and it's Yankos against the world. And I don't think he can do it. Jensen, he is 10-2-10. The turrets will fall, and Team Liquid will find their first win of the group stage, knocking out the LEC sweethearts of G2 and getting a taste of revenge from MSI 2019.
You've got Shen, the Azir Swoop obviously is good, and Rakan in for Koala. This is, better and easier to start out team fights on the
Gemini is heading up towards that top side, but the wave does not look like it was actually able to get that full bounce in.
Yep.
DK did hold it outside, so now Bin's in trouble.
Dodge comes in, dodges down, easy taunt. If he goes for it, flashes to make it land, and they're gonna get the rest of the damage. They're gonna have it. First
Clean.
Blood.
Without him putting a counter-strike means he's gonna be gone.
They can do this dive. You just need to walk up, make him counter-strike before you start attacking him. Just try to walk up on his face, but okay, they're gonna go for it.
Instant taunt into the queue. There was no way through.
That here. He could have gone pickaxe. He could have gone Sheen. He could have done anything to, this is the 1v1. Goodbye. Angel sends
on
him out.
On the Ash, you are gonna have more arrows, more opportunities to look for that. So it does make a lot of sense. That's an option if you're feeling like you're gonna have to kind of go more for that 5v5, but here comes the dive.
Okay, ulti comes across. The ulti, he was trying to keep one Fung, I think, alive for all, but he flashed away from it, still gets dropped down. Kill goes over to Bruce, and now the re-engage comes in from Bin's teleport. Gemini very, very low. The stun comes across, and a shutdown comes through. Revenge for the ganks.
40 CS on Gemini here. Gemini had a lot more impact in those lanes. You can see PK just taunting away, but the leap strike is up, and Bin wants it.
Pull through on the Q, but Bin's feeling great on Ruin King. So teleport comes in. PK gets another shield. He's got a kite back. Flashes away for safety, and now the re-engage, the scoop back. When's the dodge gonna come up? When's the taunt gonna come back? Goes over towards Mission. Can't find the kill just yet. He's trying a lifesteal, and finally Mission finds the
kill. Looking a lot better now, and we'll see how he's gonna be able to perform in those team fights, because that really is his strength.
All right, well, here comes the taunt coming across. Finds a bit of a slow, but it's still a lot of damage. His bar keeps landing the autos, landing the Qs. Dodge comes back in yet again. PK trying to stay alive, and I don't hate this one because you can probably get your dodge back up in time. He steps sideways, gets some Ezreal shots in. He's at 100 HP, and he cannot get away. Sword Art finds himself a kill. It's 4-4. Bruce TP's in just now. Arrow might have been helpful, but never came out. And so now it's under the tower for Bruce, taking a Q, almost stunned up by Sword Art.
Yeah, that Q lands, he's just dead, so. A little bit risky, though. I mean, he's the same level as the solo laners right now on Machi. He's two levels up on Gemini. I'm really we see Rakan is here, the Volley Bear. But actually, really intelligent Pink Ward. He anticipates where that would be if it was warded over to execute on it, because thus far, they haven't been super proactive with Shenaults and Rakan engages.
Big stun, though, on the front line. Goodbye to Koala. Re-engage, not going to find either stun as Angel keeps cutting away, but Volibear is back to the re-engage in a flashless Syndra, you have to believe, gets chopped
Great.
Down.
A loud Bin to have a lot of free time, and now it's potentially a smite fight over this, but Nidalee's up two levels and has Q execute.
Missions here, though, and with the chance of a scoop, it's SOFM pushed away. The flash combo going for this one, SOFM.
Stun isn't available, though.
Waiting for the way to get over the wall. Ulti from Bard to buy some time, and he's just kiting around. He's waiting for his team. Javelin, oh, you gotta be kidding me. It's taken away. SFM gets it. Magical Journey out for Sword Art. Re-engage for Koala, puts down a half HP. One flung over the wall. Nearly lands the ultimate. That would have been the kill. It's gonna be the kite away for Machi still, though. Well done to SFM for getting that one, and now Gemini is on the run. A half HP. Wants in for more. Two more will kill him, gets the shield, look for the next spell, can't land the javelin, but the red smite could mean it. Here comes Koala, flash to stay alive. He will not be stopped. SFM goes for the pounce reset, goes to jump over the wall, gets away. He can't keep getting away with it, and yet he does.
Paralegue and Freak just chasing down multiple members. Shen even TPing in to try to stop it, but Machi was so uncoordinated on that turn. You know, Volibear looked like just didn't have his cute result. Gets stolen away at very low health. Gotta be frustrating for him.
This is time around, they grab second Drake here. So Machi on the way towards Ocean Soul. Gemini slowed up though. Dodgelin comes in. They can wait around for this one, but now it's timed out. And PK has to be on the run. Thankfully, he has dodge, gets away. But the re-engage, a double root. This is gonna be the play. Sword Art does not find the stun though. Still gonna be enough to chase on down. PK forced to run. Javelin gonna land on a tank. And it's gonna be Machi running away just barely.
I mean, all of a sudden, Suning's up 3,000 gold, right? You know, this was a Machi advantage. And now they are falling pretty far behind. SOFM really starting to take over this game, it feels like. They're going for the scoop, though. Nice pick.
Nice Rima Shuffle does find him a kill, but as you mentioned, a 3,000 gold lead. That could be a kill on the bottom side as the turret falls down. Looks like everyone else is going to stay alive over there, but it looked like danger.
Teamfight style build instead of the split push. He can go towards Death Dance as well, and that can be very effective.
Ooh, nice play by Koala. Arrows landed perfectly good.
Isn't that threatening? We'll see what Machi can get done here.
One Fung marks Koala, push them away. Nice Bard ulti, Sword Art once that's one up. Easy Q, gonna find only a slow on a PK, couldn't find the stun. Angel finds the stun though, and now he's gonna be left alone. Ulti not gonna kill, exhaust is good. Taunt is even better. Angel will barely fall, but two kills go back as he and One Fung pick up two, and now Mission's gotta be careful. Getting shot over the wall, and Bin finds the third. Slows down on a Koala.
If you give this up when you're already falling behind in the split push so heavily, you're losing some of these skirmishes, it's gonna be really, really tough.
Difference 4,000. Yeah, 2v5, not gonna happen. Well, smite at SFM guaranteed.
So as long as it's not that 100-0 fight, Suning don't really care if Jax gets chipped.
Nope, completely fine with this
All quadrants of their jungle. They're losing in the 1v1, and you have no damage here to even threaten Bin.
A stun and a slow. He saves the counter-check now for the double stun to go for a kill. It forces the Shen ult. Without anyone else in range, that is a cooldown that could have been used for a flank play and now can no longer happen. Limiting the options. Machi got cracked open. That inhibitor going to fall as well, most likely.
Everyone has played this game where the split pusher is really strong, no one can answer him, and you just kind of get stuck running around trying to patch all the holes. It's like you're in a sinking ship, right? And you don't have enough hands to plug all the holes in it. But Machi have got to find an engage, and if they don't find an engage, the game is over. So, Koala, your time is now. You got to go in. You have the flash ult. You got to try to find.
At best, we can clear the way for the top side. This turret's lost about a quarter of its health. Middle inhibitor now actually gone. We have a Huan Feng that is at least one thing missing, but Machi blew two ults to make it happen and got nothing.
Exactly, and I mean, PK used his teleport, his ult. Now they're committing down to Jax on this bottom side. He may go down, but he might not even be able to get killed.
Great dodge, some great play by PK to make sure that was still there for Bruce to accomplish. He'll claim that one. Drake 3 comes through, and Ocean Souls in 5 minutes in less. You gotta be kidding!
Draper,
it's still about a minute-long cooldown. He's not going to get the steal. He's going to find a stun. Maybe there's at least a chance at a kill. Not going to find his way in. Gemini, so that's going to be them trying to run away. They get the taunt, though, onto Angel. Can they kill him? Over the wall he goes. Looking at a big knockup. It's not going to be enough. Kill number one. Kill number two for Huan Feng. Now over the wall. It's time to get a third. Bruce is running away as fast as he can. There's a triple. There's looking at the Quadra, but it's going to be SFM claiming the fifth. The Quadra's going to be good enough, and it's time to go for the base. Suning going to end the first round. Robin 2-1. Machi made him work for it off the top lane camp, but it was not enough. The better team today, the better team next week most likely as well. Suning tied for first at the top of the group to close out the first round. Robin.
Machi really did make him work for it. I think a lot of people are going to be stepping up and taking notice of how strong this team is. But Suning's map, trading into the Maokai, utilizing the Bellow's Breath, being able to get those brittle procs on Maokai. But that being every three thereafter is nice, and they're going in.
They find the stun. They find some damage on a carrier there. The charge comes forward, and he's already burned the flash. There is no way out. Jungle ganks are how you make this matchup work. And first blood
comes. It should be FlyQuest. They had the push. Well done there. But you are seeing advantages being created in the lanes by the DRX members. You know, Chovy's such a good...
Flash W, let's see what you got. I guess no Flash, but maybe Ult W. Regardless, yes, Flash to safety is the trade. I think that's worth. Now we got another trade up the top side.
It's coming.
Looking for the stun. We've got everyone else coming around. Now the first one is not going to land, but his ult's going to buy a lot of space. The Flash follow. They need this kill in a door, and they trade blows back and forth. And Solo with some help from his teammates.
Finds down. On that, there is the replay. We see Pioshik escaping. The turret taken here. You know, you have the winning 2v2, and Ignar is roaming. Not to punish just yet, but we do see Power of Evil moving down here, and he has his ultimate available.
Fence
could come
near.
Down the steal.
They find the stun. This could be an easy steal, easy shockwave, easy burst damage.
Thanks for the leash.
This should be an easy pickup, and that is a dragon.
You shouldn't bother.
Unless you get a miracle steal, Q, good smite. That's going to go for Pioshik, and Santorin could ult away. But suddenly, Ignar wants in by himself. Blast Plant pops in time. No easy re-engage. Flash to safety, but an easy chase down for Pioshik. Stun's still going to drop. How about the re-engage on Adorin? Shockwave autos. That's one kill for one. But now, Turtle has to cleanse, has to flash. Kiting away, finds the slow. The chase in for Pioshik. The flash in for depth, and he finds the headshot kill. Looking for a sleep now as well, and DRX have turned the corner. 3-1 instantly. In the team fight.
What a throw from Ignar, honestly. FlyQuest, I liked the attempt at the smite steal, but what was that engage? It's just a one-man mission there from Ignar. The rest of the team tries to stay around and bail him out, and they're probably going to lose. Well, they lost three members. They almost lost four there. And that went with the Ash ultimate, every ultimate on cooldown to take down the tank. So the carry.
Seraph City popped the extra shield just to make sure it was all okay. Now, it was FlyQuest who grabbed Drake number three. Now, a 4,000 gold difference is better than three Drakes, but a soul nearly makes up that gold difference. So if this happens in the next few minutes, it gets
another
a bit
tower,
closer.
Though.
Yes, it is. It's mid lane tier two drop, the gold lead growing farther.
Have that completed, but he's going to be incredibly strong when he does get it completed. A much higher DPS build then going to win this fight, but it's tough. You have one side completely walled off by the traps. You can see Pantheon is looking for an angle to ultimate. They are going to fight this, and I think we're going to go right now.
Here comes the play. The 5-on-5 maybe decide the game. Can they find the back line? So far, so good. Maokai roots up three. Ignar's got to run away. He can't find anything. A nice flash away keeps Solo away. Now Chovy's going to find damage to the side lane. Going to find himself the first
sleep.
The shockwave will not find the kill. Pioshik read it, and he got the Lamb's Respite. And now it's time to kill the rest of FlyQuest, and they take the dirt nap.
Huge gold lead they had to get a 5-0 ace, the dragon, and the baron all at once. This one is all but wrapped up now. Was a good attempt at the shockwave there from Power of Evil, but not quite enough.
Happens.
It does happen. Not quite enough to actually one round Pioshik there, but was close. Pioshik fast enough on the ultimate.
Yeah, I mean, he ulted pre-shockwave. He's like, okay, the ball's on me. Let's just shockwave. The only way we lose is if I get one shot, because that would have been two kills. But now look for the re-engage. A shockwave on a two. Chovy is caught up, but he has a flash. He's going to go to the wall. Can they get the rest, though? They're going to try to find Doran. He flashes away back to his turret, but it's still a 3 or a 4-on-1. Doran should not live here. He's going to dodge the first knockup, the first stun. They will find the kill. One Baron buff is gone, but that is a very, very small consolation prize.
You know what I will say? I like how aggressive FlyQuest has stayed in the two games that they've fallen really far behind, both in the top now, so he is ridiculously strong at this point in the game, going for that crit build. DRX, they have the Baron buff, they have every sieging tool you can imagine. Walk up, drop the traps, slowly poke away, shield up the Caitlyn, shield up the Kindred, let them hit that turret. FlyQuest are just going to try their very best to hold on, to wave clear, to hope you find a miracle engage, because that's really the only chance you have to get back in this game. If DRX play it safe, play it slowly, you can just slowly knock down these turrets.
Death has flash, Karia has flash, Pioshik has that, as well as the ulti. It's going to be hard to find backline access. Turret will live for now as Baron ticks down, 38 seconds remaining, but a new wave shows up, and that's going to be a turret dropping. FlyQuest lose control of their bottom inhibitor. Mid
Maokai's top
opened up as well. Maokai in the top side does have teleport, but FlyQuest, oh no, PoE, he cannot find the shockwave death. What a beautiful play, flashes forward, solo kills Power of Evil, and without a carry standing, look at the rest of this damage. Yeah, you can block it, but it's time to kill the base. A perfect cleanse, Karia goes back up, finds a bit more, re-engage, gonna look at the best they can, but no asleep on solo means there's no ult. Pioshik is unstoppable, and there is nothing left for FlyQuest to do. DRX in pretty dominant fashion. Once 20 minutes came around, they took control. A bit of damage coming back around, a single kill on the board, but it's not gonna be enough. DRX take control, a second place in the group, the way it was expected coming in. FlyQuest made him work for it, but it's still gonna be a likely 30-minute victory. We wait for the minion wave to drop down the backdoor bonus. The Nexus will fall, and DRX take down FlyQuest in 30 minutes.
What a way to finish it there. Def doing his best Syndra cosplay.
Taking the Lee Sin jungle. So AP in the bottom lane in the form of Karthus alongside Nautilus. AP in the mid lane in the form of Syndra. And then some physical damage on the top side of the map with Lee Sin jungle and Camille.
He's actually cancelled that. This is a great opportunity for UOL.
Ananasa going in. Boss going to land the stun. 369 has the flash, has the counter strike. He's going to dodge a few shots, gets the double stun off. But Ananasa is still on the chase and first blood to the Unicorn.
Really nicely
done. Look to utilize the fact that 369 does not have his flash. Now 369 has the ult, has the counter-strike available. There's the Sonic Wave, the dash in with a hookshot. Hexag Ultimatum coming out as Anasik looks to jump back into this fight. 369, very healthy, empowered auto-attack. And Ananasik feels the brunt of 369. Boss now trying to trade, but 369 is having none of this. In a 2v1, the Dawning Shadow to help him out. Chases down Boss. Corrupting Potion's not going to be enough damage.
Wow. I was looking at that play and thinking Ananasik is only level 5. There's a real world where he could die here. No flash on Nomads.
Karsa flashes in and knocks him back with the barrel, and top esports get 2 quick kills. Here's the Requiem though, and Knight can really only pray to some miracle to keep him alive.
Game. Of course, ever since we've moved into international competition, average Drakes have kind of moved much later and later, largely because the bot lane match, of course, Knight should be spotted. Boss knows this is coming. Let's see if he can outplay.
Teleport immediately from Nomads. Knight's going to get jumped on. The Hexagold made him, knocks him back as well. Nomads looking for the damage, but there's the explosive cast, and Nomads has to flash across the wall, and Boss just doesn't have the DPS to kill Knight. Cullen comes out, doesn't hit anyone, but Boss is bonked in the head by 369.
How can they be that good at outplaying that situation? UOL are going to try and make this cross-map play. Let's see if they can at the very least get something back.
Yanju is the one who's first hooked. Sonic Wave coming out. Depth charge used, but here's the counter TP as 369 can join this fray. He's gone back to base. He's got more items, and with the counter strike, he doesn't quite get onto Santas. Santas has to burn the flash.
He rolls a 9, right? I don't want to be the top lane on the other side of that.
What if this is a 6, you know what I mean?
Oh my goodness. Gadget now caught underneath the tower. Yanja coming across. Jackie Love using those long-range autos, and Knight just comes in for the double shot and the kill. Yanja didn't pop the thick skin, and maybe could have kind of the expectation for this game where Unicorns had a good few forays. They won a few battles, but
you know what I'm talking about? And because of how aggressive he is on the champion, he reaches those points much later as the engage comes in from Karsa.
And all it takes is a single misstep. Make sure no one could ever kill him. Support. Anyway, Top Esports going to use the Rift Herald in the mid lane here to try and batter down at this tier one. It goes. And
going now for objectives, whether it be Drakes, Heralds, Towers, they're always make sure that they'll go as far as they possibly can until they recognize, okay, we've pushed it a little bit too far, then they'll look to disengage. There's another example, 369, he should be safe though.
I mean, he might just be able to win this. The depth shot's gonna lock him up. There's the counter-strike, he dives onto Hananasik and he just kills him. 369 still trading, Gadget trying to land the lay waste. Can't do it, it's a double for 369. It's 6-12-18.
Then the Senna ultimate came through and that gave him just enough shielding to be able to get that additional kill as well. And off the back of that, Knight is going to secure a tier 2 in the bot lane as well. Beautiful stuff from the top laner of Top Esports.
But he was a little bit greedy going for the Scuttle Crab, which is why he was slightly out of position in the first place. TP coming in behind here is 369. Well, he can smell blood in the water, as can the rest of Top Esports. Might be gifted over to Jackie Love. It is, as he secures the kill. Gadget didn't have 369 jump over there. It was just Yianja messing around with Ananasik. They could have taken it. The Wall of Pain coming down here in the mid lane as the dragon goes across towards Top Esports. Yianja's actually stepping forward. Gadget exhausted. Gadget's just dead. Does have the Requiem, but there's no real lasting damage yet on top. Yianja's the one caught out. Thick skin, not hot. Dredge line coming out as well as Jackie Love tries to turn the damage back around. Knight now dashing forward. Last embrace going to hit onto Santos, but Boss dives in with a Hexagon Ultimatum. Gets one, gets a double. Jackie Love turns it back around. Jackie Love survived through the Unleashed Power. And here comes the Dawning Shadow as 369 dives onto the back line. Only Santos and Ananasik left alive. 369 gets one. And most Jackie Love for 369 as Knight and Casa look for Boss in the top lane. Casa's popped the Predator. Boss pops the hookshot. But here comes Knight. Just needs those auto attacks. The Hexagon Ultimatum has been used by Boss. Casa able to pop the stopwatch. And Top Esports get another kill. But here's the secondary front of the fight. And we keep seeing Top do this. Santos engaged onto Yianja. And here comes Ananasik trying to dive onto Jackie Love. The Sonic Wave, not quite enough damage. He dashes forward with the safeguard. Santos now targeting the backline, but the shutdown comes down. And that's two quick kills. Here's 369, though. And he's not happy that you just killed his teammate. Another two goes over to Knight and Santos. The last man left standing. He is hoping for some way out of this, but 369 is having none of it.
Yuwell trying to make these fights to clean things up. Top Esports now going to secure the Baron. All five members are going to get it as well. And now it's just...
I'll be honest, that TP kind of sucked a little bit.
It was a power play, Medic.
What, for the tier 1 and a tier 2? See the mid wave coming in. It's going to get that Baron buff enabled on it. 369 can rotate across, but Boss is actually going to dive on him. In the 1v1, I'm not sure you win. Gadget trying to put the Skittles down. The lay waste connecting. 369 forced away. Unicorns of Love losing their mid lane tier 3 as this happens. As Knight just chunks it down. Unicorns still standing firm for the moment, but 11,000 gold down. It's a very precarious position for them. Knight dives forward, exhausted straight away. The dredge line doesn't connect. Santos tries to get onto Knight, but there's the Devourer. And immediately, the Lucian spat back out, and he goes straight for the kill. One down, two to follow as Ananasik falls. The third goes down as Gadget is also deleted from Summoner's Rift. Boss is flashing in. Will land the kick to the back of the Lucian to get a counter kill for the Unicorns, but it's only No Man's and Boss.
Well, okay, I didn't appreciate that. I thought that they would... They would actually just go straight for the Drake. You know what? They're going to take the tower to answer back. He's able to come out ahead and safely. He doesn't get the Camille ultimate, not the Camille ultimate, the Senna ultimate to keep him alive during the use of the Karthus ult.
So Santos and Ananasik believe they have caught Jackie Love. What they don't realize is the only ambulance being called is for them. But here goes Ananasik diving forward. Jackie Love should be able to get away. Ananasik still chasing him. 369 very low, and there's the shutdown. Unicorns, I thought they'd lost the fight. I thought they'd caught them out, but instead, Top Esports only able to trade a 1-for-1. Stacks now, so has that enhanced range. Is in such a powerful position. Infinity, and she's four items.
They know exactly where Unicorns of Love are. Root gonna come out from Jackie Love. Oh, 369 is now here.
Boss is down in the bottom lane. So 369 being here is just a little bit of bouncer duty for him. Ananasik's trying to get in, but there is the explosive cask. Ananasik uses the kick to try and disengage. 369 manages to do it, but the last embrace is gonna hit onto Santos, and he is just swept off the face of Summoner's Rift by Jackie Love. Easy enough kill for Top Esports. Yianja going in, all on his lonesome. But No Man's and Gadget respecting the follow-up of Top.
Yes, and while I think Yuwell have been willing to skirmish, have gone for a lot of fights, this could be... Never mind. I think that they've not really been able to compete with Top Esports. Every small mistake that they've made, Top Esports have been very quick to punish dramatically. And honestly, like, while I think their draft was creative, I think the Senna, the ultimate, actually does a great job of countering the Karthus ultimate, something that we didn't really talk about, but we've been seeing it multiple times throughout these fights. The cross-map power that Jackie Love's ultimate does provide has been instrumental. and allowing Top Esports to come out ahead with the lead that they currently have. Now, 12k gold lead, they're knocking on the Nexus doors. UOL have one last ditch effort.
There goes Carson, there goes No Man's. Was found in No Man's Land there by Top Esports. The second kill comes down as Gadget is removed. And even through the Requiem, Jackie Love's able to survive in the stomach of Yu Yanja. And now the re-engage coming out from an Anarsic trying to get onto Knight. Does manage to take one, but 369 is chasing Unicorns back onto their fountain. Top Esports, 3-0 in their first three games, and they haven't even looked close, Vedi. Are still undefeated as Boss dives in, but Top should just be able to close this one out. The Nexus will fall after they get their final kill. And Top Esports go into the second.
I think that the Azir acting as a disengage tool to some of the hard engage tools that Fnatic have could be quite strong, because when you look at the range differential, Gen G have quite the advantage. You know, Short Life does have as well. You have to imagine that that's going to be very valuable, as already Fnatic going for a very potent all-in at level one.
Yeah, you get so many stuns off as Hillisand here. Leona has so much power. Heal coming out. Life is dead. First blood to Fnatic in the bottom lane.
Hovering around. Selfmade spots him, and he has no flash.
But Life should have his E, but Smokescreen's going to stop him. Uses the Grand Entrance to get out of it. And they're going to chase him down. Life flashed on by Selfmade. Ruler's the next target. Has to jump underneath the turret. No one has taken tower aggro yet. Selfmade looking to take it first. The end of the line comes out. One more auto is enough, and Selfmade gets it. 3-0 and 1,500 gold lead to Fnatic.
And Genji's bot lane is just crumbling right now. And it's all because of this summoner spell choice. What was supposed to be about aggression, finding early skirmishes. Oh, Fnatic's gonna go for another dive.
Ula gets Zenith bladed, the stun coming out. Here's the TP from Genji though, and Fnatic maybe have overstepped. Selfmade gets another kill. BDD coming in, another TP from Rascal. Hitasang and Selfmade need to try and get out of this, but they do not have the summoners. Two kills back over to Genji.
So Genji are finally all invested. Now here comes a TP from Ornn.
Life still only level 3, no flash. Flash Shield of Daybreak, and that's the stun on Ruler. He hasn't got a summoner to get away, and he is locked up underneath the tower.
And this was the TP play. They still have ways to bounce back in this game.
It's going to be close. Flash Smite from Clid to secure it. Selfmade tries to turn it back around. The smokescreen used. Clid's going to try and jump with the wall, but can't get there in time. Selfmade goes, well, you can have the held, but I'll take your life.
We'll see if that was worth it for Clid. Obviously, very debatable, the value of this Rift Herald. Rascal now could be in trouble.
Hillisang on his way up here as well. Surfman's going to chase him down. Nemesis has moved his way towards this top lane, and Rascal's forced underneath the tower. Now, the flash is about 15 seconds away. Hillisang Hex flashes in, and there's the TP burnt from Life. The Rakan's going to join the fray and will be able to protect his Renekton for the moment. But actually, Rascal going back here. Clid is on his way. Hillisang setting up for the stun. Rascal almost has the dominance, but he just doesn't have it in time. And now Life's the next target. He doesn't have flash, but Clid should be in range for him to battle dance away. TCS lead for Reckless. He's already got a Mana Mune stacking up. Clid has no flash, but the Zenith Blade goes wide, and Hillisang is yet to hit 6. Selfmade, though, is going to proc the red buff slow, and there's the stun, and Clid is done for. Fnatic get their 8th kill of the game.
We thought about how this early game was going to look, right? Gen G wanted to play through the top side of the map. BDD on this Azir should be able to
your Azir, he is your late game insurance to a degree. So having him have extra items is very powerful. Nemesis with the Shockwave as BDD shuffled him back. Selfmade's going to try and dive in here. Clid is almost just deleted. Selfmade trying to get those autos in, but BDD is standing in the way. Here's the Dawning Shadow to help out Selfmade. BDD forced back underneath his tower. The end of the line doesn't connect. And Life is there in time to help out his mid.
So Gen G are finally able to find a skirmish that goes in their favor. Good use of the ultimate from BDD to be able to shut down Nemesis with the help of Clid. Now, Gen G continuing on the offensive. Double TP.
I love this proactivity from Gen G. They are not willing to sit on their laurels and let Fnatic scale up. And here is the damage. And there is the first kill. Reckless already down. Hillisang now underneath the tower. Isn't going to survive for long. Rascal can tank this for days. And it's a double for BDD.
Excellent commitment. In a position where he can get a little bit of free farm, a little bit of solo experience, and a little bit of a break, to say the least, because of the amount of pressure that's been put on him. Selfmade showcasing some of the power of this lethality. Graves, very little armor on the enemy team right now, and Hillisang looking for Rascal. Don't overcommit, Hillisang.
So this is something Hillisang does all the time, which is like, he doesn't let you back. Yep. It's just like, hey, I'm just gonna put my face in here, make sure that you don't back. Sometimes he overcommits, as you say, but there he was just making sure that Rascal had to waste a couple of extra seconds. Mid lane tower goes down.
Now Gen G can look for a potential dive in the top lane. Of course, no wave is stacked. Whippo should really consider resetting here, though. That's a lot of damage, and Life is going to spot him out.
Life pops the quickness, and Whippo forced underneath the tower. Nemesis is going to TP in. Whippo knocked up, taken out by Clid. Dawning Shadow too late. Nemesis gives you the full 6 stack. and not taking it on self maybe because he needs that extra lethality, that extra burst damage.
Well, the opposition has been great at punishing.
Yeah.
And I think that's what I've enjoyed so much. It's constantly been a punish game. Who's making those little mistakes that the enemy team can then find an opportunity to get that advantage on? You can see like a lot of the outer towers are now falling. The outer of these fights should be played. We want to see patience from Gen.G, but we haven't seen that this game as they're looking to dive Whip once again.
Dominus propped, Call of the Forge God being used as well. The Battle Dance is going to do a lot of work here as life gets the kill. It's just so much fun to watch. It's like two boxers in a ring, just exchanging blows
yes,
and
sure.
looking for a little weakness in the armor of their opponents.
Very far behind in terms of his itemization. He was shut down very hard in the early game, and there's very little that Ruler could do about it. And now the action doesn't slow down as Whippo is looking for a play.
Flash Zenith Blade there from Hillersang missed, but there's the knock-up into the Solar Flare, into the Shockwave, into a very dead Croc.
In the tower, that's a lot of farm that's being lost.
Gen.G giving this one up.
Okay,
it's only second dragon.
I mean, it's not unreasonable to concede.
Really good flank position here is Hillersang and Reckless maybe have overstepped. Selfmade coming in from the bottom side of the fight. There's the Call of the Forge God. Only hits onto Life, but he can dodge back. Not if he's knocked up. Whippo takes the kill. Life is down. Scary prospect. Fnatic actually gaining control of the mid lane here as well, but Gen.G looking for flank. Life doesn't have flash, but has the exhaust, has the cleanse. Rascal coming in from the top has already popped that Dominus and then straight into the face of Selfmade. Hillersang trading here, and the TP comes in from the Ornn as he tries to dive onto the back line. Call of the Forge God comes out. There's the quickness. Call of the Forge God goes the wrong way, but the Dawning Shadow keeps Whippo alive. And there's the knockup, and there's a double, and there's one more. Ruler falls. BDD shuffles in, but the Emperor can do nothing in the face of Fnatic. Four quick kills to Fnatic.
That was unbelievable. Fnatic come out ahead. They're looking for the final kill.
Reckless chases him down. The Last Embrace finds its mark. The final auto is enough. Fnatic find an ace at 27 minutes, and they're looking for the base.
Look at the death timers right now, Medic. Fnatic may be looking for the game. They have a stacked wave in mid. They're looking to knock down the inhibitor. All five members alive. I think that could be it.
In a game that has been back and forth, Fnatic find the mistake from Gen.G. They're on the Nexus Towers. It's only Life alive to try and spend. The exhaust goes down onto Reckless, but Life is no longer. Nemesis takes him down. The Nexus Towers fall. And Fnatic bounce back after a disappointing performance against LGD to topple the undefeated Gen.G.
What a crazy game. Gives you strong 2v2. Potential all-in, but of course you have to be very careful with the Bard in the bot lane. And what I think is very interesting as well is this Orianna answer to the LeBlanc. I think that Syndra is a little bit more of a skill man. They realized that Mark was posturing very aggressively.
And now the hook on the Doublelift. Doublelift might even be dead here. The Ignite goes down. Doublelift trying to escape it. He's already burnt heal, and Kramer gets first blood in the bottom lane.
Huge for the LGD 2v2. It's just such a good magic resistance item. Meanwhile, Biofrost in the bot lane.
Going in with the Magical Journey, Speaker's going to join them as well. Mark immediately hooks the Graves, and Biofrost doesn't quite land the stun and has to flash away. Shen can come down here, has the Stand United, Bjergsen's joined the fray. 3v4 right now. Of course, there's the Stand United coming out from Broken Blade as he comes down towards the bottom lane. It's a 5v3 underneath the tower, and LGG are trying to survive. Bjergsen dives in, there's one, Mark down. TSM start to call the alarm bells and retreat as another...
to flash very early on at the risk of getting stunned up. You can see on your screen as well on the bottom left, people are dying right now.
This is great from TSM. They've actually just caught Long Xing out on a rotation, it seems. Went up towards the Rift Herald and have another look at this play underneath the tower.
Good interrupt from Mark there to stop the taunt.
Just a second, Peanut, Mark and Shia have been spotted out. Bjergsen on a ward, but here we go for the big fight. All of LGD in the back of the pit. The Root comes down, the Shockwave pulls back Speaker. Mark re-engages onto Biofrost. Now Shia stepping forward. TSM retreating just a tad as here comes Kramer from the middle lane. Last Embrace doesn't quite connect, but Biofrost is still left for the Wolves. Shie will take him. And the Rift Herald was secured, though, by TSM.
So initially, that 4v3 looked great for TSM. But then they realized, don't have enough damage to win out on this fight. Looks like we're going to have to disengage from this one. And unfortunately for them, they end up losing a member. Now Peanut in the top lane.
Broken Blade still has Flash, but he's going to go to sleep and is sliced up in his dream.
Of course, they did get themselves the Rift Herald. Doublelift did get a lot of free farm down towards the bot lane. Now Biofrost back in top lane.
Long Xing, he's just feeling the hurt as all of TSM continue to dive on him. You can see Bjergsen's coming up through that Tri-Bush as well. TP's expended by LGD to try and disengage. Collateral damage. Bjergsen double pop, dive straight in, can't hit Long Xing, and there's the Dawning Shadow. Peanut and Xie now very healthy. Bjergsen chased away. And it was a little bit too greedy. Proactively, it worked out so well for them, and now they're trying to fight around. The Dragon Doublelift dived in, stolen away. The smite from Speaker. Mark stunned up, and Speaker's on the chase. Dredgeline's going to get Mark just that little bit of distance, but Speaker is having none of it. He's chasing him down, looking for the kill. Doesn't have flash, but does have the dash. Speaker gets the Nautilus.
And now And now they're in trouble because Speaker just gets ulted.
Loading Lullaby onto Speaker. Temper Fate will keep him alive for the moment. Bjergsen's coming in to try and help out his jungler. Watch out. Eat is Speaker. Mark goes in. There's the shotgun. Misses Xie. Caught out just a little bit. Broken Blade comes in with the Sand United trying to join the team, but now he's in the midst of LGD. And it's a 5v1. That's an unfair fight. LGD get their fifth of the game.
And you can finding these advantages, and a lot of it started with the bot lane 2v2, getting that kill onto Double Lift. The fact that they've been able to find these multiple picks onto TSM has resulted in them being in a very commanding position. Now look at them, they're just taking down these outer towers. They don't need a Rift Herald, they don't need to trade it for another objective.
It's just combos to really be able to catch people out. So you can see now Bjergsen working his way down towards bot. In case Kramer had stayed around, he hasn't. They're going to give the gold across towards Bjergsen down in that bottom lane and just try and funnel as many resources onto this LeBlanc as possible.
Exactly that, Medic. They're trying to make Bjergsen the man in this game. Oh, that's huge.
Noting Lullaby coming up, the knock-up. There's the double sleep. Watch out. Eat goes Biofrost. And the Tempered Fate can't save him in time. Bjergsen is on the bottom.
And Broken Blade trying to push through the top lane so that you can try and trade something back for this Drake. But
you've got the Ludens finished on the LeBlanc. You've got the Mana Mune stacking up. You see Bjergsen trying to trade here. And the Stand United, you've got these proactive plays. They dodge away from the Shockwave. And they just take down Xie. Oh, it's a campus
TSM,
two behind them.
They've overstayed.
Speaker caught out to start off, and here comes Xie. He's not happy with the fact he was just killed. Speaker killed by Peanut. Teleport
from the LeBlanc because LGD, they're looking for a fight.
Bio first caught in the last embrace. Teleport coming in. There's a flank position here for Bjergsen. Rift Herald was popped. Broken Blade jumping in, trying to get the Torn off. Lungjing's already dived under the back line, and Speaker was his target. On the front line is Broken Blade. Bjergsen being forced away. The Stand United just being used for the shield because you know that Broken Blade was gonna die. Speaker down as well. Lungjing trading against Bjergsen and Double Lift. He'll get removed from the fray. But now Kramer is on the hunt. So are Mark, so is Xie. Bjergsen, their first target, flash in. The Ball of Death finds its mark. Double Lift stunned against the opposite wall, and Kramer just needs a few autos to finish it off. Xie takes it. LGD find a resounding teamfight in the river.
And even though TSM gained access to the river first, LGD didn't care. They just walked through mid lane into the river and said, we're looking for a fight. We're ready to go. We have also hit our item spikes. They drop the Rift Herald mid. They get themselves another tower. They're going to secure the second Drake of the game. Beautiful fight for LGD. They're going to propel the goal. They choke points, and then as LGD walk in, that is when you pick them off. You shouldn't be going for
it. Go for it. The chains still connect. Bjergsen just needs to jump in. He gets it in the end. I thought for a second maybe he misstepped.
4v5, we don't care. They run TSM down. They force them out. Now TSM is looking for a pick.
Remember, no flash on Kramer. Broken Blade just looking to catch out Kramer and Double Lift flash.
Look at the pings in the mid lane from LGD. They're just like, let's go mid, let's go mid.
Double Lift has no flash. He's got no flash. He used it already, and Mark locks him down, and Double Lift is dead. Now TSM are looking for a pick in the side lane, but this might just be the inhibitor in the mid lane, Vedius.
I mean, we were talking about it, right? Like, LGD, they'll punish these mistakes. They're going to interrupt the backs as well. Beautiful ultimate there from Kramer. The TP going to be forced out, but that's the inhibitor gun. The damage has been done. Down mid, and then Double Lift tries to hold the line, uses his E too early, immediately gets punished by Mark. So down this tier one, but LGD not too upset about that. At this point in the game, losing that objective for them. Ending first week 0-3 is not how they wanted to start their world. Bjergsen now goes in to get a bit of poke off, but LGD, considering how their play-in started, I think expectations were that they would not be in this kind of position. They're only lost so far in group stage.
TSM, this is the moment to fight. 4,000 HP on the Dragon. TSM looking for the flank. Bjergsen trying to come in from the side, but already Stand United has been used, and Bjergsen's jumped into the pit. Host goes in, Speaker called out, and there is the Dragon secured by Speaker. Team Liquid, TSM are able to fight this one out. Biofrost forced back, but you can see Double Lift has been caught. He is dead. Biofrost is next on the menu, and although you got the Dragon, you do not win the fight. TSM, LGD on the front foot now. Biofrost being forced away by Peanut. The Swirl Seed goes wide, but it's only Broken Blade and Peanut left alive. Biofrost left alive. Biofrost will just about escape with a final Caretaker Shrine. Peanut looking for the Swirl Seed, can't land it. Swings around the hammer. Mark goes down, but the rest of LGD are pushing in the mid lane. Inhibitor their target, and maybe even more than that. 13 seconds on Speaker, 17 on Bjergsen. Broken Blade being forced away here by Peanut, and the rest of LGD actually just want this kill. Teleport used, as Broken Blade will be able to escape, doesn't die in time. He gets back to the Nexus Towers, and the tier two in the bottom lane will be forfeit as well. TSM.
Like, he has no other choice, unless Broken Blade can drop the control ward right here. Ah, he's sleeping in behind them. This is his way into the back line. Here we go.
6,000 HP on the Baron. LGD in a little bit of two minds, deciding whether they want to fight it or whether they want to fight TSM. They force TSM back. Bjergsen is still in a very good flank position, not spotted on any vision. Broken Blade, the one hooked up here. Bjergsen is in the perfect spot to catch out. Kramer flashes away from the chains and just about survives. The shockwave hits on two. Double of kills Kramer, but the shockwave is massive for Xie. And now LGD just rampage through the TSM backline. Double of tries to cleanse and get himself away. Can dash in just a second. The missing shots are hitting. There's the arcane shift across the wall, but Lung Xing is having none of it. He will chase him down. Double of once again trying to get away from this mark. Ignites him. The Ruthless Predator stun connects, and that is it. Only Bjergsen left alive for TSM.
That was the flank for Bjergsen, but it was the fight for LGD. Longjin is going to end the fight by killing Bjergsen at the very end, and LGD now with four members strong are looking to end the game.
Try as they might, TSM could not find the win. LGD too strong on the day. They will tie up with Gen.G and Fnatic at 2-1 in this group.
Beautiful team fight at the end there from LGD. Xie once again.
Of the LCS teams and who could be the front runner. And a lot of what we heard was from several analysts.